Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on gate question paper solution and discussion in mechanical engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 44. We are going to discuss the subject fluid mechanics. The questions from the gate question paper in fluid statics and pressure measurement. The first question from the question paper 1994 GATE 1994, bodies in flotation to be in stable equilibrium, the necessary and the sufficient condition is that the center of gravity is located below. So, the buoyancy, the topic is buoyancy. For equilibrium, the for stable equilibrium, what is the condition? So, the for stable equilibrium condition of a floating body, the metacentric height should be positive. So, the metacentric height positive means center of gravity lies below the metacenter. That is the condition. So, the center of gravity is located below the metacenter. That is the answer. So, the fill up the blank, the correct answer is metacenter. The condition is the center of gravity is located below the metacenter. A mercury manometer is used to measure the static pressure at a point in water pipe as shown in the figure. The level difference of mercury in the two limbs is 10 millimeter. The gauge pressure at this point is, there are four options given, 1236 Pascal, 1333 Pascal, 0 Pascal, 98 Pascal. So, this is the pipeline through which the water is flowing, and you have a U-tube manometer with the mercury as the manometric fluid. The head difference is 10 millimeter. Now, the answer is 1236 Pascal. That is the correct answer, and we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the diagram once again. The specific gravity of water, 1. The specific gravity of mercury is 13.6, and difference in head x value is 10 millimeter, which is 0.01 meter of mercury. 10 millimeter of mercury, which is 0.01 meter of mercury. The gauge pressure in meter of water column, HW equal to x into specific gravity of mercury divided by specific gravity of water minus 1, which is 0.01 into 13.6 divided by 1 minus 1 equal to 0.126 meter of water. Now, the gauge pressure in Pascal, so we have calculated meter of water, we have to calculate in the Pascal, P equal to rho W G into HW. So, rho W is 1000, G is 9.81 and HW is 0.126, which is 1236 Pascal. This is the answer to the problem. A static fluid can have, there are four options, non-zero normal and shear stress, negative normal stress and zero shear stress, positive normal stress and zero shear stress, zero normal stress and non-zero shear stress. So, fluid at static. So, look at here. So, this is a beaker or a vessel with water. The water pressure is a water tank. You consider this as a water tank. The water pressure is acting downward. So, in static fluid, the shear stress is 0 because there is no relative motion in the fluid. So, shear stress equal to 0. The pressure is present which is normal to the surface, and always compressive nature. So, it is acting downward, always compressive nature. The compressive normal stress is considered as negative. So, there is no shear stress, and the compressive stress, normal stress is negative. So, the answer is negative normal stress and zero shear stress. Zero shear stress because there is no relative motion between the fluid particle. Negative normal stress because it is acting downward, it is compressive in nature. A cylindrical body of cross-sectional area A, height h and density rho s is immersed to a depth of h in the liquid of density rho and tied to a bottom with a string. The tension in the string is, so look at the problem again, a cylindrical body of cross-sectional area A, height h and density rho s. So, this is the material property. Density rho s is immersed into a depth of h in a liquid of density rho tied to the bottom of with a string. What is the tension in the string? So, there are four options, rho g h a, rho s minus rho into g h a, rho minus rho s into g h a, rho h minus rho s h into g a. So the answer, correct answer is rho h minus rho s into h. So rho s the density of the material, h is the height of the cylindrical body, rho is the density of the fluid, h is the height at which it is being immersed, and g is the acceleration due to gravity, a is the cross sectional area. So we will see how. So this is the arrangement. So we have a body, cylindrical body of height h, and it is immersed to a height of small h in the water, in some liquid. So the it is acting. So cross sectional area equal to a is tied with the bottom with a string. T is the tension in the string in Newton. So downward force due to the cylindrical body, W equal to m into g. So mass rho s into g into h. Area into h is the volume into density is the mass multiplied by the g, acceleration due to gravity, that gives the weight of the body, cylindrical body. Buoyancy force equal to weight of the water displaced. So buoyancy force, weight of the water displaced, Fb equal to rho into a into h into g. So rho is the density of the liquid, a is the cross sectional area of the cylindrical body, h is the height up to which it is being immersed in the liquid, and g is the acceleration due to gravity. Then for equilibrium condition, Fb equal to W into T. So W is the weight of the body, Fb is the buoyancy force, T is the tension in the string. So tension in the string equal to Fb minus W. So rho into Fb, already we have Fb equal to rho into A into H into G minus rho S into A into G H into G. So combining the terms, rho into H minus rho S into capital H into A into G. This is the answer to the problem. This is from next question from 2010 question paper. For stability of the floating body under influence of gravity alone, which of the following statement is true? Metacenter should be below the center of gravity, metacenter should be above the center of gravity, metacenter and the center of gravity must lie in the same horizontal line, metacenter and the center of gravity must lie in the same vertical line. So the answer, for stable equilibrium condition of a floating body, the metacenter height should be positive, that means metacenter should be above the center of gravity. The answer is metacenter should be above the center of gravity. Answer is B. The next question from GATE 2014 question paper. For completely submerged body with the center of gravity G and center of buoyancy B, the condition of stability will be G is located below B. So B is the center of buoyancy, G is the center of gravity. G is located above the B. G and B are coincident, independent of location of G and B. So this is the completely submerged body of center of gravity. G is the center of gravity, B is the center of buoyancy, W is the weight of the body. So the answer is G is located below the B. So B is the center of buoyancy. So center of gravity, G is located below the center of buoyancy. That is the answer to the problem. Next question paper from the GATE 2016 question paper. For a floating body, buoyant force must act at the centroid of the floating body, center of gravity of the body, centroid of the fluid vertically below the body, centroid of displaced fluid. The answer is centroid of displaced fluid. The next question from 2018 question paper. A cylindrical wooden block by length 50 cm is floating in water in such a way that its axis is vertical. The density of the wood and the water, 800 kg per meter cube and 1000 kg per meter cube respectively. Submerged depth, that is depth of immersion in centimeter of the cylinder, is dash. So the answer is, so look at the problem. So this is the wooden block of height 0.5 meter, density 800 kg per meter cube. It is immersed in the water of density 1000 kg per meter cube. So it is immersed to a depth of D. Submerged to a depth of D. We have to calculate the D. That is the question. So for equilibrium, weight of the wooden cylinder is equal to buoyant force, buoyancy force. So weight of the wooden cylinder equal to rho A H into G. So rho is the density, A is the cross sectional area, H is the height of the cylinder, and G is the acceleration due to gravity. This is equal to buoyancy force equal to rho W A into D into G. Rho W, what amount of water displaced. Rho W into area is the, A is the area, D is the depth to which it is immersed, and G is the acceleration due to gravity. So deleting the common term. So capital A is common and G is common. So that is deleted. So we have rho into H is equal to rho W into D. So rho is density of the wooden block 800 into height equal to 0.5 meter equal to rho W equal to 1000 into D is the diameter, D is the depth equal to D. So solving the problem, solving the equation, diameter depth equal to 0.4 meter, which is 40 centimeter. So the answer is 40 centimeter. The depth to which it is immersed equal to 40 centimeter. The next question is from 1988 question paper. A circular plate 1 meter diameter is submerged vertically in water such that its upper edge is 8 meter below the free surface of water. Total hydrostatic pressure on one side of the plate is 6.7 kN, 65.4 kN, 45 kN, 77 kN. A circular plate of 1 meter diameter submerged vertically in water such that its upper edge is 8 meter below the free surface of water. What is the total hydrostatic pressure on one side of the plate? So the answer is 65.4 kN. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the circular plate submerged in the water. The diameter of the circular plate is 1 meter and the height of the edge from the free surface is y, which is 8 meter. And h bar is the center of gravity. The height of center of gravity from the free surface and the p is the center of pressure, which is at the distance of h star. Now we have to calculate the force. We have to calculate only the force here. So f equal to rho g a into h bar. So rho g a into h bar equal to rho g into pi by 4 d square into y plus d by 2. So calculating all the, substituting all the values, the hydrostatic force f equal to 1000 into 9.81 into 3.14 divided by 4 into 1 square into 8 plus 1 by 2, which is 65,457 newton, which is 65.4 kilonewton. The next question from 1990 question paper. The cross-sectional area of one limb of U-tube manometer is 500 times larger than the other, so that the pressure difference between the two limbs can be determined by measuring the H on one limb of the manometer. The percentage of error involved is 1.0, 0.5, 0.2, 0.05. So this is the arrangement. We have a larger limb of diameter of the area. The area is 500 times than the smaller limb. And delta H is the height difference and the H is the height of the liquid in the smaller diameter limb. So area of the larger limb equal to 500 times the area of the smaller limb. So the A, capital A equal to 500 times of small a. So capital A is the area of the cross section of the larger limb and the small a is the area of the smaller limb. So A, capital A equal to 500 into small a. So volume of the fluid in the larger limb equal to volume of the fluid in the smaller limb. So substituting capital A into delta H equal to small a into H. So rearranging the terms, delta H by H, the percentage of error is equal to small a by capital A, which is 1 by 500, is equal to 0.002, which is 0.2%. The answer is 0.2%. The error associated with the measurement is 0.2%. The next question from 1995 question paper. The force F needed to support the liquid of density D and the vessel on top is, so we have the equation GD into HA minus capital H minus small h into A, GD into capital H A, GD into capital H small a, GD into capital H minus small h into A. So this is the arrangement. We have a vessel of tube of diameter area A and it is supporting a liquid, right? The total height equal to H and the height in the tube equal to small h, and we have a piston here, frictionless piston of area capital A. So capital A is the area of the friction, area of the piston. Small a is the area of the tube, h is the height of the liquid in the smaller tube, and h, capital H is the height, the total height of the liquid. Now what is the force here required? That is what the question. So the F force equal to pressure into area. So F equal to dgh into A. So dgh into A. So the answer is dgdh into A. So the force required equal to the density G into H. That is what the total pressure force into area, total pressure of the fluid into area equal to capital A. The next question from 1997 question paper, refer to the figure, the absolute pressure of gas A in the tube, in the bulb is, we have four options, 771.2 millimeter of mercury, 752.65 millimeter of mercury, 767.35 millimeter of mercury, 748.8 millimeter of mercury. We look at the diagram, we analyze the diagram, so we have a pressure, a pipeline of where the some fluid is flowing with the pressure PA. And there are different liquid. So here we have one liquid, the fluid flowing through the pipeline. So this is the liquid height and this is the manometric fluid. And on the right side, we have another liquid of A, height A. So the height is 5 centimeter. Here the height is 10 centimeter. And here the manometric fluid height, height difference is 2 centimeter. And density of this manometric fluid equal to 13.6 grams per milliliter. And here the atmospheric pressure is acting 760 millimeter of mercury. That is the atmospheric pressure. Now we have to take dE as the datum. dE as the datum. So pressure, we just write the equation for the balancing the two forces, forces acting on the two limb. Left side limb PA into 1000 into 9.81 into 0.17. So this is the some fluid. We take water is the fluid. The height equal to 10 plus 7, 5 plus 2, 17 centimeter, 0.17 meter, 9.81. Rho is the density. We take 1000. And on the other side, so this is from the datum, with reference datum, this is the force acting, pressure acting on the one side. Pressure acting on the other side. So this is the datum. 13.6 grams, so the density is 13,600 into 9.81 into height equal to 0.02 plus 1000 into 9.81. So we take the area, the has, I mean the block area is water. So of density 1000, 1000 into 9.81 into 0.05 height plus 13,600 into 9.81, it is 760 millimeter of mercury, which is 0.76. So, the atmospheric pressure in terms of newtons per meter square. So, 13,600 9.81 to 0.76. So, solving this equation, the pressure PA equal to 102,887 newtons per meter square. But we have to calculate in millimeter of mercury. So, this PA equal to in millimeter of mercury, PA equal to 13,600 into 9.81 into height in head of, I mean height of mercury column. So, 102,887 equal to 13,600 9.81 to height of mercury column. So, height of the mercury column equal to 0.7712 meter of mercury, which is 771.2 millimeter of mercury. The answer is option A, 771.2 millimeter of mercury. The next question from 2000, gate 2000 question paper, in a given figure, if the pressure of the gas in the bulb A, capital A, is 50 centimeter of mercury vacuum and atmospheric pressure is 76 centimeter of mercury, then height of the column H is equal to 26 centimeter, 50 centimeter, 76 centimeter, 126 centimeter. So here we have some mercury is the fluid, we have the fluid is rising in the mercury in the pipeline. So here we have vacuum pressure. And what is the height? What is the height? So, atmospheric pressure is acting on the surface. So, PA equal to 50 centimeter of mercury, which is 26 centimeter of, 50 centimeter of vacuum, which is 26 centimeter of mercury. Because 50 centimeter of vacuum means 760 millimeter of mercury, right? 760 millimeter of mercury is one atmospheric pressure. 760 equal to 76 centimeter of mercury. So, 76 minus 50 equal to 26 centimeter of mercury. So, PA equal to 26 centimeter of mercury. Using the principles of manometer, P atmosphere equal to capital H plus PA. So, P atmosphere equal to 76 centimeter of mercury, which is equal to H minus 26 equal to H equal to 50 centimeter of mercury. The height equal to 50 centimeter of mercury. So the answer is 50 centimeter. So the horizontal, next question paper from 2001 question. The horizontal and vertical hydrostatic forces Fx and Fy on a semicircular gate having a width W into the plane of figure R. So we have the diagram, we have a gate, right, of radius R, W is vertical distance, gate width is W, gate width is W, that means perpendicular to the plane of the paper. So we here Fx equal to rho g h r into W and Fy equal to 0. This is the answer, one answer. Second answer, Fx equal to 2 rho g h r W and Fy equal to 0. The third answer, Fx equal to 2 rho g h r W and Fy equal to rho g W r square by 2. And finally, we have another option, Fx equal to 2 rho g h r w and Fy equal to pi rho g w r square by 2. So analyze the diagram, analyzing the diagram, width of the gate equal to W, radius r equal to, radius of the gate r equal to r, and the height of the center, height of the center from the free surface of water is h, and the rho is the density of the fluid, rho is the density of the fluid. These are all the parameter involved in the problem. The correct answer is Fx equal to 2 rho g h r w and Fy equal to pi rho g w r square by 2. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the diagram once again. Fx is the horizontal static, horizontal hydrostatic force. Fx equal to pressure into projected area. So the pressure equal to rho g h, pressure equal to rho g h, and the projected area equal to 2 r into W. So that is the for horizontal force. So Fy is the vertical hydrostatic force. Fy equal to weight of the fluid above the semicircular gate. This is M into G. M into G. M equal to rho into V. V is the volume into G. So volume of the gate. So rho G into pi R square by 2 into W. So the answer is rho G pi R square W by 2. So the horizontal force Fx equal to rho G into 2 rho g h r w and Fy equal to rho g pi r square w by 2. That is the answer. The next question from 2004 question paper. The gauge pressure g1 and g2 installed on the system show the pressure of pg1 equal to 5 bar and pg2 equal to 1 bar. The value of unknown pressure p. So we have the two gauges G1 and G2, atmospheric pressure equal to 1.01 bar, G1 shows 5 bar, G2 shows 1 bar, what is the value of P? So unknown pressure P equal to PG1 plus PG2 equal to 5 plus 1 equal to 6 bar, the absolute pressure equal to 6 plus 1.01 equal to 7.01 bar. So we have to calculate the unknown absolute pressure, which is 7.01 bar. We take another question from gate 2013 question paper. A hinged gate of length 5 meter inclined at 30 degree with the horizontal and with a water of mass M its left, on its left, is shown in the figure below. So we have a gate. So we have some liquid water here of particular mass. The gate inclined at angle 30 degree. Density of the water is 1000 kg per meter cube. The minimum mass of the gate in kilogram per unit width. So width is perpendicular to the board and length is 5 meter. Required to keep it closed. So some force is acting due to the water. The pressure force is acting due to the water and the gate should be kept in closed condition. The gate is of length 5 meter, inclined at 30 degree. It is hinged here. It should be kept in the closed condition. So what is the mass of the gate material, mass of the gate required to keep the gate in the closed condition? There are four options given. The options are 5000 kilogram, 6600 kilogram, 7546 kilogram, 9623 kilogram. So the correct answer is 9623 kilogram. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the diagram. The length of the gate equal to 5 meter and this is the center of gravity, this is the center of pressure. So h bar is the height of the center of gravity from the free surface of water. Total height equal to 2.5 meter. So this is g, 2.5 meter, 5 meter height. So half of the height. So center of gravity ICG equal to W L cube divided by 2. W is the width of the gate perpendicular to the plane, 1 meter. Length equal to 5 meter. 5 cube divided by 12 equal to 10.42. And the center of pressure H bar equal to H bar plus ICG into sin square theta by A H bar equal to 1.25 plus 10.42 into sin square 30 divided by 1 into 5 into 1.25 equal to 1.667 meter. And the L star equal to H star by sin theta. From the trigonometry, L star equal to H star by sin theta, sin 30 equal to 1.667 divided by sin 30 equal to 3.334 meter. Now the moment of the force, you take momentum about the hinge, momentum F. So before taking the momentum, we have to calculate the force. The force equal to rho g into H bar. So the force is equal to rho g into H bar into area, which is 1000 into 9.81 into 1.25 into 1 into 5. This is the force due to the water, which is 61,312.5 newton. Now taking the moment, F into L star. F is the force of water. L star is the place at which it is acting. This is equal to M into G into X. So M is the mass of the gate. G is the acceleration due to gravity, that is weight of the gate, into X is the position at which the force is acting. So Mg into X equal 2.5 into cos 30. So substituting all the values, 61,312.5 into 3.334 equal to mass of the gate into 9.81 into 2.5 into cos 30. Solving this equation, left hand side is 204,415.875 equal to 21.239 into M. So M equal to 9,624.55, which is approximately equal to 9623 kilogram. That is the answer to the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, listen to the video lectures for your better learning, and thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll continue with the solution for the gate question paper in the fluid statics in the next video lecture also.